Why we hold the king up as an icon? If you look within the scriptures, you'll find it. The revelation speak of the man who up on his vesture and his tie is a name written, King of Kings and Lord of Lords. Emperor Haile Selassie is the only man today that has that title. The book of Acts 2:29 say, men and brethren, let me freely speak unto you of the patriarch David, who is both dead and buried, but whose sepulchre is with us on this day. Knowing that God has sworn it an oath, that out of the line of Jesse, Jesse Black, them always say Jesse Black, like you black like Jesse and Elgate. Out of the line of Jesse will I rise up, Christ, to again sit on his father David, show that I'm Christ in past and gone a long time, you know. Well, Emperor Haile Selassie is the returned Messiah. The Christ in that day is the Rastafari this day, the Emperor Haile Selassie.
His Majesty is the Most High from the foundation of the universe. When he was in the temple, when that temple was called Ayos the Christ, and after the resurrection and departure, he said he shall return the second time in like manner. Mm-hmm. And when he comes, he shall sit upon his father's throne. And his throne shall remain and abide forever and ever. And we are seeing at the same time, Ayos the Christ, at that time, he never sit upon his throne. But this time we talk, heal to the high, mighty and mighty, great David, great us all. In his time appointed, his reign on earth began. He come to break down oppression and to set his captives free, and to take away transgression and to rule in equality. He's the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, not the tribe of Judah.
So the first coming, according to Ras over here, it wasn't the fullness. So the second coming is the fullness. Is the second coming here? Is he here yet?
Yeah, yeah.